love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. In the presence of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we've come together to witness the marriage of Michelle and Justin, to pray for God's blessing on them, and to share their joy and celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of creation through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that as man and woman grow together in love and trust, they shall be united with one another in heart, body, and mind, as Christ is united with his bride, the Church. The gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children are nurtured and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship and comfort, and grow to maturity in love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ, with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and of loyalty, which all should uphold and honour. It enriches our society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Michelle and Justin are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to the other and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. And we pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they may fulfill God's purposes for the whole of their earthly life together. But first, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. That's good. We'll go ahead. The vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows the secrets of all our hearts. Therefore, if either of you know a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Justin, will you take Michelle to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Michelle, will you take Justin to be your husband? Will you love him, honour him, comfort him and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
And now I ask all of you to respond to my question with the words, "We will." Will you, the families and friends of Justin and Michelle, support and uphold them in their marriage, now and in the years to come?
We will.
Let us pray. God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessing upon Justin and Michelle, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Who has the honour of presenting this woman to this man? Justin and Michelle, I now invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and of his people. I, Justin, take you, Michelle.
I, Justin, take you, Michelle.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Justin and to Michelle a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The wedding rings that they're going to exchange are endless. They're a complete circle. And they're symbolic of this marriage on this day and of their life together. There is no ending. It is forever. Michelle,
Michelle,
as a sign of our marriage,
as a sign of our marriage,
with my body, I am.
My body, I
all that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In the presence of God, and before this congregation, Justice and Michelle have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. I'm going to wrap my stole round their hands now. This is the stole that I wore when I became a priest, and it binds me to God and to the church. And this binds them together in God's love, in this church. So may those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Please, would you sit? God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him, both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. We're now going to have our first reading this afternoon.
Pardon mistakes, without forgetting but with remembering
want to learn from them. The key to love is trust. Though dark doubts lay in hollow thoughts, it must shine brightly on with reassuring radiance that suppresses fear with faith. The key to love is sharing. Facing the good fortunes as well as the bad, together both conquering problems forever, searching for ways to intensify your happiness. The key to love is giving. Without thought of return, but with help of just a simple smile and giving in, but never. The key to love is respect, realizing that you are two separate people with different ideas, that you belong with each other, and share a mutual bond. Now, the art of good marriage. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembered to say, I love you, at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together and facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers the whole family. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right person, it is being the right partner.
Or boastful or rude.
seek to support and uphold. And we are here as family and friends, the church community, to support Michelle and Justin in the vows they have made today. God promises to be with us always, but his love does protect us from hard times. In the service today, Justin and Michelle have committed themselves to facing life's challenges together, to be there in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, for richer and poorer. And let's be clear just how daunting and demanding those promises are, because none of us can predict what the years ahead will bring. Michelle and Justin will undertake to share everything, not just the material things, but their joys, their failings, their fears, all the stuff that enables us to be ourselves, to be vulnerable, open and honest with someone who will help us grow and fulfill our potential. Marriage asks 100% commitment from each partner, to keep loving whatever happens, however we feel, and whatever life throws at us, to the end of our lives. Michelle and Justin have already had the challenges of changing jobs and juggling family life and work. They know that every marriage has to be worked at. I like that advice. It's not just marrying the right person, it's being the right partner. And mindful of all the advice that they have heard today from their friends in those readings, let me urge you always to make space for God in your lives, in prayer and worship, for God to nurture and increase in you those qualities that St. Paul lists, those beautiful qualities which transform our lives and make us the people we are meant to be. Let me end with a wonderful image from the film and the book, Captain Kureme's Mandolin, which some of you will know. Love is what is left over when being in love has burned away. Your mother and I had it. We had roots which grew together underground, and when all the pretty blossom had fallen from our branches, we found we were one tree, not two. Two becoming one is at the heart of marriage. So we pray for Michelle and Justin that they will grow in love and unity throughout their lives together and come to know the fulfillment and wholeness that God ordains for all in this sacrament of marriage. Amen. So we're going to stand to sing our first hymn together, and during the last verse we're going to go to sign the register, so the witnesses will need to come with us. Would you like to stand for our first hymn?
So would you like to sit or kneel for the prayers? If I ask Justin and Michelle to come and kneel. And the response to the prayers today, when I say Lord of life and love, the response is, hear our prayer. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of love, we thank and praise you for bringing Michelle and Justin to this day, and we pray for them. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
May their marriage be life-giving and lifelong, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace. May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust, and continue to enjoy so much of their life together. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around them. May their love overflow to friends and neighbours in need, and embrace those in distress. Father, we give thanks for their family life, and especially for their little daughter, Kristen Michelle, to date their greatest accomplishment. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
Father, may they nurture their family with devotion, see their children grow in body, mind and spirit, and come at last to the end of their lives with hearts content and in joyful anticipation of heaven. And here we remember those who are in heaven, especially Justin's Nana, Mavis Bowen, and Michelle's granddad, Roy Spahn, who will be rejoicing with God and for us on this special day. Lord of life and love,
hear our prayer.
And we join our prayers together in the words of the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you, all those you love and for whom you pray, this day and always. Amen. And now we stand for our final hymn, Jerusalem, during which the bride and groom and witnesses will come to sign the register.